Earlier this week, I put out a step-by-step tutorial on how to get set up on Clubhouse. What is Clubhouse? Clubhouse is the latest social media app which is focused on live audio. You join rooms, you have conversations with anybody in your field. There's celebrities on it. Elon Musk was chatting on it. Mark Zuckerberg was chatting on it. You're on basically on live audio-only calls with anybody and everybody. And it's a quick, easy way to build an enormous following on the platform because it's a very new platform. So your organic reach is huge, but it's also a quick way to build trust, to build relationships, to build connections. It's an incredible platform. I'm still getting used to it, but I know a lot of other people are wondering what it is and some of the best practices. So I already put out the step-by-step instructional video, which I'll link in the description of this video on how to use it. But what I thought I would do today is discuss what to expect when you're on Clubhouse. A little bit of context. So this video may be confusing if you've never heard of Clubhouse, but if you have started to investigate it and want to learn a little bit more about it, hopefully this video can help you out. Also, after I sort of discuss some of the things to expect on Clubhouse, then I'm going to speak about some of the strategies that I've seen as I've done some research as well on how to build a following on Clubhouse. I hope you enjoy. So the first thing that you should know about Clubhouse is that everybody is there to give an immense amount of value, which is a nice change because when you're there and you're speaking, it's very hard to hide behind essentially shitty content. Which you can't really do, you know, if you go on Twitter or you go on Instagram, there's anonymous accounts. There's accounts that post a lot of fluff. There's accounts that post things that aren't necessarily valuable for many of us, especially if you're watching this, you're probably, you have some understanding of the power of social media. You're an early adopter. You understand how you can market on these platforms. And you're somebody that wants value out of social media, especially if you're an early adopter. So you can appreciate that Clubhouse offers an incredible amount of value. And the people on Clubhouse offer an incredible amount of value. Not only are you going to get people, when they have an opportunity to actually speak in a room, giving you in a very succinct, concise way, what they think to be the most valuable bit of information they can offer to contribute to the conversation, you're also going to get some very known individuals, some celebrities in a variety of different fields. It could be business, it could not be business, but you're going to get celebrities also contributing to the conversation. And a lot of these individuals, especially entrepreneurs, business leaders, venture capitalists, these are incredibly smart people. So you're going to get the best of everyone when they're on Clubhouse and when they're participating. And this is because you're on display, you're speaking live in real time, and you also don't have a lot of time to mess around. There's really no value in you not contributing to the conversation when you get a chance or an opportunity to speak. It's also an incredibly personal social media platform. There is no wall, there is no posting, there is no liking, there is no DMing. Your voice, your personality is on display all the time. So when you're communicating with individuals, you are putting yourself out there, but you're building trust in a much greater way than you can behind the screen of any other social media platform. Think about if you're on a Zoom call or a video call or a phone call with some of the most brilliant minds in the world. That's what Clubhouse is like. And because you're able to give that value, nothing is lost in text. Your voice inflections, the way you communicate, the tone, the verbiage, the words you use, all of that is put on display. It's front and center, and people immediately understand what you're trying to discuss and the point you're trying to make, which makes communication, trust, and the ability to build authentic relations with all these incredible people that much quicker and that much easier. We also spoke briefly about how to use Clubhouse to integrate with your other social media apps and to leverage, for example, Twitter and Instagram to give a little bit more information about who you are if you're on Clubhouse. So Clubhouse links to both of those platforms. So if you're using Clubhouse and you're using it effectively, you will start to notice an increased follower count on your other social media platforms as well, because when somebody goes to check out your Clubhouse profile, you're a one-click link away from your other social media platforms. Another thing that you should be aware of with Clubhouse is that it is still early days. It's still a new platform, which means that there are less creators than consumers. A lot of people aren't consuming. So you have an opportunity to leverage the massive organic reach that Clubhouse has, meaning that if you do join and you get over your fear of joining and you speak, you'll notice increases in your follower count quite quickly compared to some other older platforms like Instagram or Twitter, where it takes a lot of content over a significant period of time to really build momentum, especially if you're starting from scratch. And lastly, one more really important point. If you don't feel comfortable speaking right away, that's fine. If you do join a room, nobody's going to pressure you into speaking. If you do want to speak, you can quote unquote raise your hand on the app. Or if you don't want to speak, you can just sit and listen and understand how the flow of the conversation goes, understand what it's like to actually participate. And if you want to leave the room, you can just leave the room and nobody will even be the wiser. So it's nothing that you should be concerned of or scared of, which I know causes a lot of people apprehension. It caused me apprehension when I was first joining because it's so new. It's something that we've never done before. At the end of the day, Clubhouse is really the expedited launching pad for relationships. It allows you to quickly, succinctly make connections with incredibly valuable people in at a rate that really you can't see on any other social media platform. So that's what the benefit of Clubhouse and some of the things that you should expect if you're using. All right, now that we've covered some of the things that you should expect when you're on the platform, let's speak about what I'm sure some of you are trying to figure out. How do I use it to build an audience? Of course, there's a lot of benefits to Clubhouse that aren't just racking up a follower count. But like any social media platform, you have the opportunity to build an audience. When you have that opportunity to build an audience, you can get your message out to more individuals. So how do you build an audience on Clubhouse? What are some of the best practices? Number one, focus on community building. Clubhouse is a large community. That's the core principle of the product. Now, what do I mean by focus on community building? Well, build rooms and create rooms that basically are focused on topics that you're passionate about. This is not rocket science. On any other social media platform, if you're creating good content and you want to attract the right tribe, you need to focus on speaking about things that you're passionate about and that you actually care about. Simon Sinek is famous for saying, how did he get so good at public speaking? Well, he says, well, I cheated a little bit. I just spoke about things that I'm passionate about. And he goes on to say, there's a difference between passion and energy. You can always jump around on stage and you can always drink too much coffee and speak at a higher rate, but that's not true passion. That's just energy. If you know what you live and breathe for, if you were going to go out into the world and ask, what is one thing that describes me? Think about that answer. That's who you are. And that's what you want to discuss. That's what you want to create rooms about. Things that you are truly passionate about, because what that will do is it will bring people in who are also passionate about those things. That's your tribe. That's who you actually want to communicate with. But also, it'll be easier for you. It'll be more comfortable because these are things that you know inside and out. These are things that you research in your downtime. These are things that you just love to discuss and to learn about. So focus on building a community, focus on creating rooms about things that you're passionate about, and that will make everything easier. It'll help you build your following because people will recognize you as a subject matter expert or an authority in that area, and you will be able to build a tribe much easier because people, like-minded individuals who are also passionate about those things, will find these rooms and will want to communicate, engage, and follow you. Number two, be relevant. Understand what's going on in your business, your industry. Understand the gossip, the latest and greatest. It doesn't really matter what industry or what job function or what you're discussing, but you should be up to date because Clubhouse is a truly social platform. Right now, it's hot, it's relevant. You had Elon Musk on it just a little bit ago. People don't want information on Clubhouse because, again, everybody has a short period of time to chat, to actually speak. And also, it's a very time-consuming platform for the people who are listening. So make sure that when you do speak or when you do bring something up, it's relevant, it's impactful, it's something that is new, is groundbreaking, is disruptive, is not just going to be something that people cared about 10 years ago? What, again, any business, any industry, you want to be relevant. So if you're going to prep for Clubhouse, this is a good exercise in just being an interesting, educated individual in your field. Do a little bit of research, understand what's topical, what's trending, and prepare a little bit. Have some content that you want to discuss that's going to get a conversation going and that's going to get people interested, because the more interesting you are on Clubhouse and on any social platform, but definitely on Clubhouse, the more it's going to resonate with people and the more those people are going to want to follow you. Again, about building your following, so be interesting. Number three, we've already spoken about this in the walkthrough of the platform, but optimize your profile. Remember, when you search for somebody's, when you search for a certain topic on Clubhouse, the search is optimized by keyword. So if you want to be known as a marketer or in social media or as a dog groomer or as a venture capitalist or as, it doesn't really matter. If you want to be known as something, make sure the keywords that are associated with that thing or that job are populate your profile. So that when some, especially your username, so that when somebody looks up marketing, they'll see your name. If your name is, for example, Scott D. Clary Marketing or otherwise, right? So put those keywords in your profile and then also explain who you are in your profile. So you always want to fill that out. That's probably one of the most important ways to build a following, is to give people a little bit more information as to who you are. Because if nobody's heard, if people haven't heard of you before and they go to your profile, you want to make sure that when you're on, when they're on your profile, they see, and they see interesting information, they'll convert into a follower. So you have to make sure that you optimize your profile for the keywords that you want to have associated with you and your brand. And then also make sure that there's information there so that people will want to follow you. They'll understand what you do and they'll find you interesting. Number four, invite influencers onto the platform. It's going to be a little bit hard, but remember, if you invite somebody onto the platform with your invite links, your name will be on their profile forever. So it'll show underneath their main copy on their profile, this individual was invited by you if you invited them. So try and use your invites to get the most influential people you can onto the platform, bring them in. And that's a little bit of an incentive for you to actually invite more people on. Number five, it seems a little bit obvious, but host panels, attend rooms, raise your hand and speak. The easiest growth hack for an early social media platform is just to use it. If you just use it right now, you are going to experience insane growth on the platform. So my biggest growth hack, even though it's coming in at number five, I probably should have put it at number one, is to just use the platform and get over any sort of apprehension you have of raising your hand and raising your voice. If you have to set some time aside for it, I'd recommend setting some time aside either one day a week or perhaps to kick your morning off 1 hour in the morning, because it can get super addictive and very, very time consuming. So set some time aside, but actually engage and participate. Number six, you can actually issue announcements via Clubhouse. So you're going to have to build a little bit of a following to gain some critical mass. But once you build a following, you can keep that ball rolling. You can issue announcements. You can create news alerts. You can invite more people into your room so that your rooms have a higher chance of being popular and having great conversation in them. So once you have a following, use the announcements to communicate with everybody who's following you. And last but not least, number seven is to apply for a club. Now, the rules on how to create your own club, which is really just like an interest-based group that you moderate and you control and you can communicate with, the rules are not clear. There is a link that you can go to and you can apply to have the ability to create a club. And right now, Clubhouse can approve or not approve you. That's their prerogative. But I would suggest that if you are active on the platform, you take the opportunity and you apply to create a club so that you can build your own, not just following, but your own community within the platform. Those are my seven tips, best practices on how to build a following, how to build an audience, and how to be impactful and use the platform so that it can actually. That's a little bit just on the what to expect when you sign up and you start to use Clubhouse, as well as how to build a following on Clubhouse. I hope you enjoyed. If you like this video, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, leave a comment. If you're on Clubhouse, of course, give me a follow at Scott D. Clary, and we'll set up a room and we'll chat together. If you haven't already, please leave a comment as to what you've experienced with Clubhouse. I'm curious to get your feedback because it's such a new platform. So I want to know if you're on it, if you like it. Do you think that it's a great social media platform that you can use to build an audience? Is it too time consuming? Do you think it's just a phase or a fad that's eventually going to go away? Maybe people don't have enough time to stay on Clubhouse all day. It's a big unknown for me how long this platform is going to stay around. And I'm not sure because it's just so new and so different from everything else that I've ever used on social media. So leave some feedback below. I'm just curious as to if you're watching this, what your take on Clubhouse is. Anyways, have a great week. We'll chat again soon. Bye now.